brought to you by DK Audio.
DK Audio presents The Black History Book, Big Ideas Simply Explained, by DK, read by Dede Davi. Black history is global. It takes place in Africa, Europe, the Americas, Asia, and the Middle East. Black history is ancient, which is hardly surprising, as it was from the African continent that the very first humans emerged hundreds of thousands of years ago. Yet at various times and places, the history of black people and the history of the African continent have been marginalized or left unwritten. Black civilizations that ruled over huge swathes of the world and created great art and architecture have often been left out of the history books written in Western nations. Some European philosophers went as far as to suggest that Africa had no real history. Likewise, the centuries in which black people fought and campaigned against enslavement, colonialism, and racism were often brushed under the carpet. In the face of this, the preservation and celebration of black history has become almost sacred to many black people, particularly those whose ancestors were enslaved. Yet while black history has a very specific significance in the lives and identities of millions of black people across the world, black history itself is everyone's history. Just as you do not need to be European to be fascinated by the history of ancient Rome, you do not have to be black to be astonished by the great empire of Mali or the kingdom of Benin. Just as non-Jewish people learn about the horrors of Holocaust, all of us should learn about the horrors of slavery and of the black people who fought against it. I became interested in black history when I was a teenager. It was the place I looked to find answers, to explain the history of the British Empire, of which my interracial family was a product. It explained where the racist ideas that I saw all around me had come from, and it explained how and why those ideas had been invented. Black history also revealed to me the long history in which black people have struggled against racism and colonialism. Struggles that continue to this day, led in the 21st century by young people. This book presents black history in all its complexity, from ancient times to the debates and activisms of right now. Through its pages, we learn of Africa's true place in world history and can trace the origins of the inequalities that still shape modern societies. During the centuries in which the history of Africa was pushed to the margins and the contributions of black people to global civilization went unrecognized, the whole world was denied access to these remarkable and inspiring stories. The histories contained within these pages place the long history of Africa and her people back into the mainstream of world history to the benefit of us all. Davi Dolosuga. There's just the human race scientifically. Racism is a construct, a social construct. Toni Morrison, Black American writer, 1931 to 2019. From now on, we are no longer a colonial, but a free and independent people. Kwame Nkrumah, first president of Ghana, 1909 to 1972. Black history tells the story of black people's lives over thousands of years, from the earliest human history to now. Black people are often defined in blanket terms to mean those of recent sub-Saharan African descent. This includes people living on the African continent, descendants of enslaved Africans trafficked in the transatlantic slave trade, and those who have migrated from Africa to other parts of the world. It is, however, a generalization of quite recent origin that ignores the varied nationalities, cultures, and life experiences of black people. Diverse peoples. The earliest known humans came out of Africa more than 200,000 years ago. For generations, those who stayed on the African continent and did not migrate and form populations of Asia, Australasia, America, and Europe viewed themselves not as black, but as ethnic groups, such as the Nubians, the Yoruba, and the Swahili. These diverse peoples had, and still have, unique languages, traditions, and cultures, and remarkable and complex systems of governance. From the 16th century onwards, however, all sub-Saharan Africans began to be categorized as part of a homogeneous group. Those involved in the transatlantic slave trade and European colonialism rationalized the subordination and treatment of these varied peoples of ancient origins by claiming that they were all part of a lesser race. Centuries of oppression. European traders bought enslaved Africans from other Africans and trafficked them as cargo to the New World. There, they were sold in markets like cattle to labour in different parts of the Americas and the Caribbean, with the largest number of enslaved people arriving in Brazil. During this period, many enslaved people rebelled on the coast of West Africa, during the brutal transatlantic voyage, and in the Americas, where many worked in appalling conditions. In one of their most successful revolts, the entire enslaved population of San Domingue in the western part of Hispaniola rose up and dominated their enslavers, forming the new nation of Haiti in 1804. After centuries of enslavement and rebellions, white people in the New World and Europe at last began to view enslavement as wrong and joined black enslaved people in the fight for abolition. In 1861, civil war broke out between the slaveholding states in America's South and the non-slaveholding states of the North. The North won in 1865, and in the same year, the US abolished slavery. Abolition, however, was not a panacea for black people, and many of the formerly enslaved continued to face inequality in the New World. Black people in the US suffered under Jim Crow laws, which gave racial segregation legal force. To escape this new oppression, some of the formerly enslaved elected to move to Liberia in West Africa. This was a country newly created by white American abolitionists and others intent on resettling black people in Africa, with, however, little or no consideration for African peoples already living there. Indeed, soon after abolition, many European powers began to colonize sub-Saharan Africa, continuing the fiction that black people were a lesser race. They claimed to be civilizing Africans. At the 1884-85 Berlin Conference, several European powers carved up Africa among themselves. Britain gained power over broad swathes of West Africa, and King Leopold of Belgium secured the Congo as his private colony. No Africans were invited to the conference. By 1900, European countries controlled 90% of African land. Colonial Africa was oppressive for many black people. They rebelled against European managers who often conscripted them into forced labour systems, punishing or killing those who failed to produce enough profits. In British Nigeria, from 1929 to 1930, thousands of women revolted in a bid to redress their many grievances. Looting factories, burning down court buildings, blocking train tracks, and cutting telegraph wires. Civil rights and beyond. In the 20th century, as many black people across the world remained subordinate to people of European descent, they found power in their black identity. They expressed it in vibrant music, art, and literature, and united under the banner of blackness to form international movements. They also reclaimed earlier denigrating terms, such as Negro and coloured, to denote their solidarity. The term black became more popular only in the later 20th century. Pan-Africanism, a movement that called for all black people of African origin to unite in pursuit of common political and social goals, gradually gained traction. In 1900, Trinidadian Henry Sylvester Williams led the first Pan-African conference in London, UK, and 8 further meetings were later hosted in European and African cities and in New York. However, black people fought for their local rights too. In Africa, countries struggled for independence and an end to colonial oppression. In the US, black Americans fought for an end to segregation, while black people from French and British colonies, who had migrated to France and Britain, demanded the right to be treated as equal citizens. These fights all had varying amounts of success. Ghana gained independence in 1957. And other black African states followed suit. In the US, the landmark Brown v. Board of Education decision in 1954 helped to desegregate schools, while Britain's passing of the Race Relations Act in 1965 was a crucial first step in curbing racial discrimination. The fight goes on. the legacy of enslavement and colonialization still casts a shadow over Black lives, and the struggle for liberation continues. It is why Black Lives Matter, launched in 2013, after the acquittal of a white man who killed a Black teenager, has become a worldwide movement, highlighting the many injustices Black people face. The aim of this book, too, is to shine a spotlight on these injustices, but also to celebrate Black history and achievements, and to illustrate how Black people have influenced and transformed our modern world. Prehistory and Ancient History, before 1 CE. Circa 315,000 years ago, the earliest known human lives around this time in Jebel Irhoud, Morocco. Circa 215,000 BCE, earliest known date for human migration out of Africa, based on fossils found in Greece. Circa 12,000 years ago. The first human settlements are founded in the Fertile Crescent, including some in the Nile Valley. Circa 3,400 BCE, a monarchy is established in the African Kingdom of Nubia, one of the world's earliest civilizations. Circa 3,150 BCE, the pre-dynastic Egyptian states are unified under King Narmer, who founds the first Egyptian dynasty. 2,575 to 1,069 BCE, ancient Egyptian civilization flourishes in the Old, Middle, and New Kingdoms. Circa 1000 BCE, Bantu-speaking peoples from the Niger Delta begin to migrate southwards, dispersing their languages and cultures across Africa. 814 BCE, the Phoenicians build the city of Carthage, at a strategic location on North Africa's Mediterranean coast. 760 BCE, the Nubian Kingdom of Kush conquers Egypt, leading to the rule of the five Black pharaohs there. Circa 600 BCE, Meroe becomes the new capital of Kush following the kingdom's defeat by the Assyrians. 332 BCE, Alexander the Great, ruler of the Greek kingdom of Macedonia, conquers Egypt. He founds the city of Alexandria a year later. Circa 300 BCE, the Library of Alexandria is created by Ptolemy I Soter with the aim of collecting all of the books in the world. 146 BCE, the Romans conquer Carthage, which becomes a key port for the empire's vast trading network. Africa is not only the birthplace of Black history, but of all human history. The first Homo sapiens, humans, originated in Africa. The earliest specimen that has been found to date came from Jebel Irhoud in Morocco, and other early specimens have been found in Kenya. Human ancestors, such as Homo habilis and Homo heidelbergensis, left their mark across Africa in the form of fossils and primitive tools. Scholars now believe that our species evolved from these ancestors in multiple places in Africa, at least 315,000 years ago. Humans began to migrate out of Africa around 215,000 BCE, first into the Middle East and then onto other parts of the world. Gradually, some hunter-gatherers abandoned their nomadic lifestyle and founded the first human settlements. In the Fertile Crescent, a collective name for the Nile Valley, the Middle East, and Mesopotamia, Iraq, about 12,000 years ago. These early communities were sustained by three great rivers, the Nile, the Euphrates, and the Tigris, whose fertile floodplains provided the ideal conditions for farming to evolve. Key civilizations in Africa emerged around the 4th millennium BCE, from the appearance of Bantu-speaking peoples in the Niger Delta in 3500 BCE to the monarchy established in Nubia in 3400 BCE and the unification of pre-dynastic Egypt in 3150 BCE. Egyptian expansion. The River Nile nurtured one of the first and greatest civilizations in world history. The communities that grew up around the Nile developed rich cultures with art, languages, and religious and political systems becoming increasingly complex. By the time of the last culture of the pre-dynastic Egypt, the Nakata III, circa 3000.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.